Welcome you to my channel. I won't make you wait more. Today we will learn about how dogs learn and what we can do for help. Let's begin right now. 1. Benefits of understanding ways dogs learn. If you understand how dogs learn, it gives you the power to show your dog the way to fit harmoniously into your life. Sit, rather than jump on people, leave it, instead of eat the food that just dropped on the floor, wait, rather than dart out into traffic, walk politely by your side, instead of pull on leash. It also gives you the power to show your dog to love or even love things which may rather be scary. Noisy vacuum cleaners, going to the vet, getting a pedicure, and it can assist you understand why certain things tip the dog to be scared. You learning your keys and briefcase tips the dog off to you're leaving him alone all day. And you get into the car tips the dog off that he's going to the vet. Moreover, rain tips the dog off that loud thunder is coming soon. Let's take a look at how these two learning methods work too. Operant condition. Operant condition is one of the methods of how dogs learn. Dogs, like all animals, including humans, do things that work out well for them and stop doing things that don't. It's the kind of learning that most of us take advantage of when training our dogs. Whether it is formally in obedience class or informally at home. If a dog begs at the dinner table and someone gives him food, he will continue to beg. Begging relates to food? Excellent. I will keep begging. And if you signal your dog to sit, and when she does you give her a piece of chicken, she will be more likely to sit the next time you ask her to do so. In addition, if every time your puppy bites too hard, you get up and leave the room, your puppy will likely learn to soften up her bite. How dogs learn by classical conditioning. Dogs easily learn what predicts what in their world. Trainers often ask this sort of learning as classical conditioning. For instance, opening the treat jar predicts treats. And leashes predict walks. They learn what predicts the things they like. But they learn what predicts things they dislike or fear as well. Rain predicts thunder, an issue for those dogs who are afraid of storms. And dad grabbing his keys and briefcase predicts 8 hours of alone time. Dogs, people, and every one other animals study associations in equivalent way. And the thing is, dogs are learning from their environment during this way all the time, whether we intend them to or not. If the first few times a dog rides in a car it is to go to the vet for a scary and painful procedure. Then the dog might end up fearing the car. Though even it is later used to go to fun places. Treat your dog with care. If seeing other dogs consistently results in pain, this dog could over time become upset at the sight of other dogs. Prong collars, alongside other pieces of kit designed to harm or scare the dog to show him to prevent doing something, are a short-term solution that can cause a long-term problem. Sure, the dog will stop pulling, but he might alright also become aggressive to other dogs. That's a dangerous path you don't want to go down. On the flip side, if an individual were to offer her pup tasty treats when he walks politely past other dogs, he will learn to feel good at the sight of other dogs. And as a bonus, he'll develop some warm fuzzies to the person as well. Conclusion. Today we have collected information about how dogs learn, the benefits of understanding that, and how we should treat our dog to help them learn better. I hope it is helpful for you. Follow me for more interesting topics on dogs and training methods. Thanks for your time.